look at them and say, with man it is impossible, but not with luck. For all things are possible with luck. Welcome to this LATAM monthly restream. Tonight we have Lucas versus Pollo. Bom dia, Villmaker. So we are just waiting for Lucas for fix the LATAM internet moment. We are gonna start 18 all the way for this Mufados match. So Lucas said ready like 3 times. So now we are just waiting for another ready for Pollo. Okay, both players are ready. We're gonna start it. At the countdown of obviously 4. Bomba. Yes, I can please type the top out score for Pollo. Okay, both players started now, and Luke with some pushdown points. I hope he loses this match. Pollo with first Tetris, Lucas gonna take the triple. Still not Tetris for Lucas. Okay, Tetris for Lucas. He's at 38,000 and Pollo with another Tetris, 49,000 points. Almost one Tetris lead for Luke, but he's a bit ahead of lines because of the smoke pushdown. So this is kind of neck and neck. And Pollo with a lot of holes in his tag. Looks kind of like cool trees, but it's a taper, so it's okay. Gets a triple. He's lowering down the stack. Nice long bars. He just needs to fix the shitty parity in his floor. Okay, he's doing fine. And Lucas now with... I don't know how to count, but about like 40,000 points lead. Imagine knowing math. Okay, Pollo is... almost clean now, but he's behind still by almost 50k. But both players with now a good board, shouldn't be a problem for Pollo in post. Nice stack, Pollo. Okay, he's Tetris ready now from row 3, but he's just gonna burn this. Keep it safe because he almost dies. And now he's gonna do it. Dirty Tetris for Pollo. And now he's with a good transfer. Go to the row 0. Lucas with a 50k point lead. Lucas is ahead by like 5 lines or so. So this is still pretty much neck and neck. Good balance by Luke. Bad parity though. Okay, Tetris for Luke and Tetris for Pollo. Luke is now at 310k and Pollo is at 273. Now with another Tetris, Pollo is almost at 300k and Lucas is at 335. Pollo with some trouble in the board, but it should be fine. This is still diggable. Getting full tupper colon. Yes, nice dig by Pollo and takes the Tetris. Lucas now with a line dependency on the left. He's doing kinda bad decisions, but yeah, he gets the long bar, so. And another long bar. Lucas just got bailed. Not like Teva yesterday. So he's fine now. Okay, Lucas is now at 376 and that's the Teva misdrop and immediately tops out. So Pollo, you need 377k points to win this game. So like 2 Tetrises or like 50 singles if you wanna do the Johan strat. Okay, I typed the score, 377k, okay Pollo, that's the score you need, you're almost there, you don't need to go crazy, and it's going kinda crazy now for Pollo, because a pretty tough board and misdrops every single piece, so look how I'm gonna take this game. Kinda lucky. Unfortunate for Pollo. Lucas gonna get the first feels good man. Which I forgot what was it. No. No. There we go. 0-1. Okay, we are now waiting for Pollo with the 1 minute strat. Let's cancel Pollo's boss. Such a capitalist pig. Okay, both players ready. We're gonna count down the second game. Oh shit, wait. 3, 2, 1, Tetris. Okay. The Marxista, anti-Marxista Mario Salazar, also known as Pollo, Pollao, Pollito, Pollo. Against the capitalista, anti-capitalista Lucas da Silva, also known as Lucao, Lucas Sanchez, and Batata, which is a terrible name. both players start with one Tetris. And Insaniso is in the chat saying, Lucas Demet Obrigazao de Vanzera Pollo. Sim, sim. So, yeah, Lucas with 75k and Pollo with 72k. Pollo with some bad pieces now, but this is shit. Lucas has been playing really good, keeping the stack safe, taking the good burns, and his stack is pretty clean, which obviously is the most important thing in competition. And okay, Lucas now with 131k, ahead by almost 2 Tetrises for Pollo, which is getting in a bit of trouble, but gets the long bar. Yeah, RNG is a myth. Who fucking cares about RNG? It doesn't matter at all. Like, it has zero influence in every single game. Zero. Absolute zero. Shut up, Insaniso. Who dare you say that? Okay, Pollo now in a deep situation. This is kind of a tough board, but he's getting the exact same pieces. I mean, he's just getting bad RNG. But he's so good that he manages to slow the stack. To slow the stack, and yeah, he's just taking the safe burns. Pretty good by Pollo, not going crazy. Okay, meanwhile Lucas is at 239, so this is a pretty big lead by Lucas, although this is just the middle of the 18. Very nice placements by Lucas, fixing the stack. And Pollo now with another Tetris, almost 100k behind Lucas, which is playing really good today. Okay, so Pollo is now doing a really better job, but he's still 100k behind Lucas, and also almost the same line count. So Lucas at 335 mil puntos y Pollito a 243 mil. Sim. Both players reaching now the 100 line mark, and Lucas is still 100k points in the lead, so this is looking kind of tough for Pollo. We also know Lucas recently broke the one-off streak, so we know he's a maxed player and a 30 taper, so he can do things on post. Well, now with some burns to do in the right side for Lucas, not very dangerous, still some lines to go into transition. Gets clean pretty good. still maintaining more than a 100k lead, and Pollo is reaching transition in two more lines. So this is gonna be tough. Pollo needs a lot of points for an early top out for Lucas in the early post. Okay, so Lucas now with some burns to do to go back to the right well, and Pollo with a column 2 well, which we all know it's always very dangerous, now needs something to the right, gets two T's and gets really good burns. He might lower this down, but he does a really interesting flip on the left side and tops out. So Lucas is gonna win this game, and it's gonna be 0-2. GG's, guys. We might see a million by Lucas, but no, we know he's a really nice guy. He wouldn't do that. He's just gonna top out, and we're gonna add Lucas, his second feels good, man. We're gonna wait a bit for Pollo. Come on, Pollo, you need a comeback, you need the reverse sweep. We are hoping for a decider here. Let's go all the way to the kill screen. Show us how you do level 30. Okay, all players ready. As this is a match point, we're gonna do a 5 countdown. Tetris. Luca already started. Also, that's Pollo. This might be the first time I see Lucas doing really good in competition, despite of that team placement. He has been really, really good. Muito obrigado, Insanizo. Pelas palavras. Okay, Luke is now with 58k, and Pollo Tetris ready with 35, feeling the algae dependency, doing some burns. Yeah, he's gonna be fine. Just go brr. And now Lucas with a center well, and he does a dirty Tetris, which, let's admit, it was really good. But yeah, now having to do some more burns. But this is just neck and neck from the beginning of this game. And okay, so both player status ready. Both with 90k, taking the safe burns, getting Tetris ready. Both players with a Tetris, both goes to 121k. Nice burns by Luke. Tetris lead, but this is still pretty much tied. So this might be a better game than the last two. We hope Pollo at least win this one, so the match can keep going. He seems to be doing a lot better now. Nice decisions there by Pollo. An early tableau or whatever it is. So he's now in a kind of tough position, getting good pieces though. Yeah, nice burns. He's just gonna be fine in a few seconds. Okay. Getting in a lot of long bars now when he's trying to dig. And more long bars. But this is still kind of tough, but Pollo's doing the right movements, I think. Okay, that might have been a bit dangerous. It's a L-piece, gets the L-piece at the perfect time. Now he has a good parity and it's about to clean this. Really nice clean by Pollo there. But in the meanwhile, Luke is at 328k. 328k for Lucas, and Pollo is more than 100k behind again. So Pollo is in a pretty tough spot now, since this is the match point for Luke. He needs to cover his base pretty quick. Still has some lines for transition, and Lucas is now doing a dig, but he gets absolutely bailed with those long bars at the exact right time, and he's just gonna be fine right before transition. Pollo also with a good board, still more than 100k behind, but he's just gonna need to keep this going, maybe recover it post game. So now we enter the 19 game. Pollo needs to be careful there, because this might be it. Pollo, very nice way to fix that long bar dependency. Now, and also nice job fixing that parity there. Pollo now at 324 and Lucas at 476. So this is still a pretty big lead by Lucas, but he's going really high and hangs a C-piece in the left. So yeah, Lucas kind of slowed there, but Pollo needs to do a chase and of more than 100k points. Pollo, you need 479 to win this game and keep this match going, or you will lose and get swept by Lucas. Okay, Pollo pauses and I think he was trying to see this score. I will allow that. That pause champ. Really nice decisions there by Pollo, and really nice decision there to not fuck up the board. Doing really good burns, keeping this low. He doesn't need to go crazy now. He still has a lot of lines to chase this. with a lot of powerful miss drops, but this is still pretty cleanable. Get some good pieces and also good placements. This is kinda tough, but Pollo has this for sure. He's just wearing this down. Oh, pretty good timing in that long bar. And well, Pollo is trying to do his best, but he still needs like 3 or 4 Tetrises, and he's at level 26 now, so he has to start scoring some good shit and not only these lineup strats. Okay, Pollo needs 57k points, so that's like 2 or 3 Tetrises. Gets 1 Tetris, Pollo is just 1 Tetris away from taking this game. Kinda with a Roth board now, but okay, he's, oh my god, really really good timing in the long bar, but he needs gets the long bar when he needs it, but now he needs 6k more, takes a good burn with a long bar, he just needs to, oh my god, he takes it by 3k and less in the kill screen. That was amazing, Pollo. Nice survival until the kill screen. Pretty, pretty good game. Not very high score, but really good chase down by Pollo. So Pollo will get a feels good man because he deserves it. Now the match is 1-2-2. Yes, Pollo, we understand, we sometimes need to mute the commentator because they are assholes. It's okay, you just need to drop already to continue with this match. Yes, I will do it. I will allow it because you are Pollo. And both players are ready. We will drop a 4 condoms since this is the 4th game of the match. Let's go guys. Let's hope to see another game going to pause. Lucas now with really questionable decisions. Oh, he does a really bad misdrop in the left and a really bad placement with that square. But okay, he's now doing really good movements. That was a very nice burn with the TPs, and now he just needs to burn this down. This is a pretty decent parity, also it's kinda high, but he's doing very good burns. That was kinda dumb, but he should be fine now. He's a lot lower now, and yeah, let's just hope he burns through this. Meanwhile, Pollo not doing so good by himself. With a line dependency in the middle, gets the line. Nothing dangerous yet. And while Lucas was really high, so he needed to do some burns. Now he's probably gonna build into row 1 or whatever they call it, where he just burst through all, and now he has a really good board. Doing some more burns, although it's still ahead of Pollo by 8k. So both players started with some burns, but they are pretty much tied now. We saw last games, Lucas had a really strong lead in the 18 game. Let's hope Pollo can bring the 18 pace more high now. But that was a very nice J placement by Pollo. Now he's kind of high, but he can burn through the right. Pretty nice double with my Pollo, doing the right movements. Not going crazy, pretty good. A very nice tee, and he's almost... he uncovered it well and gets a Tetris. Okay, so now Pollo is at 114k, meanwhile Lucas is with a pretty tall board and 122k. A lot of long pieces. Long bar depends, he gets a long bar. Kind of bailed again. Now Pollo taking the lead with almost 2 Tetrises. So this is really good for Pollo. He might have gotten his confidence back after that game. Because he played really well and did a really good chase down into the kill screen, but now he's in a really kind, really monkish position. He gets a really good burn, but now he needs a long bar or whatever to burn through that column 8 or whatever. He gets a bad timing with a long bar, but he's doing a really good job with those burns and placements and gets the long bar. So now this tag is very, very lowered down. He just needs to do a few more burns. Has a few holes in the stack yet, but yeah, he should be fine now. The stack is pretty well now. Anyway, Lucas kind of fixed his board to both players around 200k at 100 lines, so this is pretty much tied, at least much more than the last games. So well, now Lucas is totally clean and scoring Tetrises, also Tetris ready, gets a Tetris and goes to 260k. Meanwhile Pollo does a really good clean there and is like a Tetris behind Lucas, but his Tetris ready again and takes the Tetris, goes to 247, now 270 for Pollo. Lucas taking back the lead. This seems to be really shitty pace by both players, but this is really tight, so this might be a really good game again. Let's hope these players get more cracked on balls since they are both tapers. Lucas is about to transition, so now he has some holes in the stack. Not something dangerous though. The safe burns to lower the stack down first before taking the statuses. And now Pollo is with a really small lead, but with kind of a better board, he just needs to... Okay, he uncovered the board and gets the Tetris with a long bar. Pollo is now at 358k, and Lucas has to do some burns. Oh, he does a pretty tough line dependency in the right, but this is still not so high. He gets the long bar to the right, he needs now a long bar in the column, but he discovers it. He has a hole still in the left side, so he has to do some more burns. Really good placements by Lucas here. Okay, feeling the line dependency was really, really good, but now with a kind of tough parity, gets really good pieces, and he's doing exactly what he's gotta do with those pieces. Okay, so Lucas is going to top out at 353, and Pollo is gonna take this game. Pollo, please don't build in this. You can top out. You are good, Pollo. GG's, Pollo. Okay, so we have a decider now. Another feels good man for Pollo. Let's do a 5 countdown now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Tetris. Okay guys, this is the last game of this match. You can say it's Vamos Lucao por amor de Jehová. Okay, I don't know how to delete a comment, so Johan, you are safe for now. Okay, both players with 2 Tetrises now, 50k points for both, with really good stacks. They are just chilling in the early game. Let's go to get better pace now, since the last one was very low for at least for Mufados level. Kind of an all for space, not so low, but kind of Pollo with. Okay, he's doing the best he can now. He's getting the right pieces, so he still can burn this through. That was really smart by Pollo. Also that, good placements. Fixing the parity there, well, kind of. Okay, Pollo still needs to dig through this. It's a long bar or whatever. It's a really good timing on that L piece. Now he is Tetris ready again. Gets the Tetris. Nice playing by Pollo. But Lucas now is 70k ahead. Well, 60k ahead. Tetris ready. Tetris for Lucas. And another Tetris for Lucas. So Luke is now at 226. And Pollo at 143k. Now with some more grass, which is just struggling a bit with getting Tetris ready and maintaining a good board. On the other hand, Lucas is doing a pretty good job still, keeping the stack safe, the parity good. Really good burn there by Lucas, not going so high, and takes the Tetris. Lucas doing a really good job here, and while Pollo is still struggling in getting some Tetrises, he has been burning a lot, and now Lucas has a bit more than 100k point lead. Still maintaining this good pace with good burns, good placements, and keeping a good stacking, not going for crazy stuff. This is a really good performance there by Lucao. This match so far, despite the early boost. dropouts. Lucas has been doing a really good job. Now Lucas with a really really good pace for competition, with more than 400k before 100 lines, and Pollo more than 100k lead behind, but he is trying to focus really hard to keeping this score going again. 30 triple for Pollo, unfortunately not gonna be a Tetris, but okay, Pollo is clean again. Let's hope he starts scoring some more points, because he's really really behind in the points now. He's getting kind of bad pieces and has a lot of way on that right side. If he wants to go back to the right, he's gonna do like 10 turns or so. So Lucas is almost 200k points in the lead. Now with a line dependency and kind of tough pieces there, but really good safe burns by Lucas. Now has a kind of tough parity, but he's again taking good burns. Okay, that was kind of risky, but he gets the Tetris there. And Pollo now in a pretty tough situation. It's a long bar or something to burn in the right. Gets the help, gets some burns, but hangs a long bar in the left. He still can get something through the left. Oh, he decides to skip that L, and he's not gonna pass that long bar through. So Pollo's gonna top out. Lucas is gonna win with 566k in level 21. Really good pace by Lucas. And GG's for both players, because that was a really good match. Found decider, and Lucas is gonna pass to Mufados. Yeah, boy, I mean, Pollo, despite the really low pace almost all those games, he did a pretty good job trying to chase down Lucas. And Lucas playing really safe in 18, but kinda bottom post. No problem, Pollo. Yeah, I really get it. I do that sometimes. But it's okay. I appreciate the good comments about the commentary. So now we are going to look someone for someone to raid. Let's raid it. Okay, let's raid Beer, since I do not want to raid JD nor mostly Tetris, because they both suck. The Beer Wizard. We're gonna go there. Thank you guys for staying and for the good comments. I hope you had a